तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिनिति नाम्ने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चाचारिणे वंशकौपतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। सो We're going over the second part, the second half of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, which is a book by Sanatana Goswami, one of the principal disciples of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
那我们一直在讲述着大伯加瓦坦甘露的第二部分，这部书的作者是Sanatana Goswami。
So it describes about the travels of a cowherd boy from Govardhan who was given a mantra by his guru, and by the power of this mantra he could travel to all the higher planets in the material world and into the spiritual world.
他是高尔丹山的一个牧牛童，名字叫高帕库马。他在物质世界旅行，然后接着又旅行到了高等星宿，最后他来到灵性世界。So
it happened, Gopkumar was able to travel into Vaikuntha, and he went to Dwarka in Vaikuntha, and then he came back to Vrindavan on earth.
旅行到了Vaikuntha，然后接着他又去了Dwarka，从Dwarka他返回了地球上的Vrindavan。And
then, when he was in Vrindavan, he was in ecstasy, and he, in the course of his ecstasy, he found himself transferred to the spiritual world. He went right into Goloka, the supreme planet in the spiritual world.
在本丹他就陷入了狂喜当中，然后后来他发现自己就被转移到了就灵性天空当中的最高的星球，至尊的星球Goloka。
So we heard he was in Goloka, and how he was surprised. Goloka just looked like Vrindavan on earth. There was practically no difference. And he was meeting different people there in Goloka. And many of them were all often in, it seemed like they were in distress, like they were crying because they were in separation from Krishna.
他们都流着泪水，因为他们体验着跟 Krishna 的分离之情。
So he asked people where was Krishna, and then he found out Krishna had gone off to the forest. So in the evening, Krishna came home from the forest along with the cows and the cowherd boy, and Gopkumar wanted to go and meet Krishna.
这些人，Krishna 到了去了哪里？然后他被告知 Krishna 去了森林。 到了晚上的时候他就会回来，然后到了晚上的时候呢，就是那些牛还有牧牛童都陪着 Krishna 一起返回，然后Gopal Kumar就想去见着 Krishna。
So Krishna was coming home in the evening and he was with all the cows and with all his cowherd boyfriends, and Krishna was playing the flute. He had the flute in his hands, and then Krishna saw Gop Kumar.
到了晚间 Krishna 就开始回家，他带着他的牛还有他的牧牛童朋友就往家朝着家走，然后他手里拿着一根笛子在吹着笛子，然后他这时候看见了 Gopal Kumar。
And when Krishna saw Gop Kumar, Krishna turned to his cowherd boyfriend Sridharma and he said to Sridharma, he said, hey, look, there's my dear friend and Sarupa. Krishna recognized Gop Kumar not as Gop Kumar, but he recognized him as a very dear friend named Sarupa.
这时候 Krishna 一眼就看见了 Gopal Kumar， 他就转头对他的朋友 Sridharma 就说道，嘿，你看，那不是我们的亲密的朋友 Sarupa 吗？这 Krishna 呢，他就一眼认出了 Gopal Kumar，他认出 Gopal Kumar 是他最亲密的朋友 Sarupa。
So Krishna saw Sarupa, remember that's the same, it's the same person as Gop Kumar. So his name on earth was Gop Kumar, but in the spiritual world his name was Sarupa. And Krishna saw him, and Krishna came running towards him to greet him.
Krishna 就看见了 Sarupa 就是跟 Gopal Kumar 是同一个人，他在地球上的名字叫 Gopal Kumar。 Krishna 看见 Gopal Kumar 之后，他就朝着他跑了过来。
So Krishna is just coming back from the forest. So when he goes to the forest, he has always peacock feather on his crown and he wears a garland of kadamba flowers.
Krishna 此时此际他是从温达文的森林返回，当他去森林放牛的时候呢，他会头插孔雀羽毛，他头戴王冠上就插着一根孔雀羽毛，他戴着kadamba花的花环。
And his body has a beautiful fragrance.
他浑身弥漫着一股花香。
And he's smiling and his eyes are beaming.
他面带微笑，他的双眼也是在笑眯眯的，在放射着光芒。
With his hand, he pushes back the hair from over his face. Because he has quite long hair, so he pushes the hair away from his eyes.
Krishna, 呢，因为他有一头长长的秀，有长长的秀发，然后当他这时候呢，他就用手把这个美丽的头发就拢到了脑后。
And because all the cows are there, there's a lot of dust. Vrindavan is quite dry, so there's a lot of dust, and the dust was all on his hair.
这母牛牛蹄扬起的尘土呢，这时候呢，就他的头上沾着Vrindavan的牛儿，他蹄子上扬起的尘土，因为Vrindavan特别干燥。
And Krishna's lotus feet are touching the earth And he appears like he's dancing as he moves.
Krishna 的莲花足，他触碰着大地。当他迈着他莲花足的时候，他就好像在跳着舞。
And Krishna's movements attract everyone, and it seems like he's walking quickly and taking big steps.
Krishna 的一举一动就吸引着众人的注目。当他向前走动的时候呢，好像他在迅速的奔跑着。
And his body is the color of the rain cloud, and but it's shining, effulgent.
他的肤色就好像雨新鲜的雨云，但是他浑身放射着熠熠的光彩。
And he's not old, he's youthful, he's a young person. Sometimes people think God must be old, but we see Krishna is never old.
他并没有一副老态龙钟的样子，而是散发着青春活力。有的时候人们以为神是一个老人，但实际上并非如此。
And his attractive features captured the hearts of all the people of Vrindavan.
他的魅力和他的俊美的容貌就吸引了 Vrindavan 所有居民的心。
So it's difficult to describe all the wonderful qualities of Krishna. He's like the ocean. Like the ocean, it's so deep, you can never know everything.
Krishna 美妙的品质是难以一一描述的，它就好像一个深不可测的海洋一般，你永远无法测度 Krishna 的诸般品质。
So the hearts of the devotees of Krishna are always attracted to him, and they never know everything about Krishna, but everything about Krishna is so attractive, so pleasing.
Krishna 就深深地吸引了所有 Vrindavan 居民的心。他的品质是这样的，众多，他们是无法了解他所有的诸般品质，但是他的每一项品质都深深地吸引了他们。
So the devotees are attracted to Krishna, and Krishna is also attracted to the devotee. Krishna's heart is always full with the thought of his devotees.
奉献者就深深受到 Krishna 的吸引。他总是在全神贯注地想着 Krishna， 而 Krishna 的心里头也装着他的奉献者，时时刻刻地想着他的奉献者。
So Krishna was running towards Gop Kumar, and he came close to Gop Kumar. He came running forward because he had so much love for his devotee.
Krishna 此时此刻呢，就奔向他的朋友。因为他心里就涌动着对他的奉献者的爱。
So when Gop Kumar saw Krishna coming towards him like that, Gop Kumar fainted in love, because seeing Krishna coming towards him, he fainted.
当 Gop Kumar 看见 Krishna 朝他跑过来之际呢，他就一下子失去了知觉，昏了过去。
So Krishna caught hold of Gop Kumar by the neck. He put his arms around his neck. But then Krishna also fell to the ground. Krishna also fainted.
这时候 Krishna 就一下子用他的臂膀就搂住了 Gop Kumar 的脖子。当 Gop Kumar 倒在地上的时候呢， Krishna 也和他一起就倒在地上失去了知觉。
Of course, Gop Kumar knows Krishna always loves his devotees, but now he sees that Krishna also he has a special love for him, for Gop Kumar. He has a special relationship with him.
知道 Krishna 钟爱他的奉献者，但此时此刻呢，他发现 Krishna 是如此的深爱着他自己。
So Gopkumar had fainted, but didn't faint for long. Quickly he came back to consciousness. But because Krishna had put his arms around his neck, he had to take Krishna's arms off from around his neck.
Gopkumar, he didn't fall on the ground for a long time. He quickly regained consciousness.然后他发现 Krishna 的臂膀还搂着他的脖子，他就把 Krishna 的臂膀从他的脖子上就拿了下来。
And so when he stood up, he saw that Krishna's on the ground, unconscious, and he's covered with dust.
当 Gopakumar 起身之后，他发现 Krishna 还躺在地上，是没有知觉。而且他身上呢都沾满了尘土。
And Krishna is he's crying so much that the tears from his eyes made all the dust around him on the road, it all became mud.
而且 Krishna 呢，他从他眼中流下的泪水呢是如此之多，以至于都把他四周的泥土都打湿了，使得他周围的泥土都变成了一片泥泞。
So at that time, some gopis came, and the gopis said, "Oh, look, who has come here? What has he done? He's put our Krishna into such a state."
这时候，有一些勾皮们走了过来，他们就是惊呼道，哦，谁来了？是谁把我们的 Krishna 置于这样的境况中？
Just see, we're the people of Vrindavan, now we're all dead. Because look at Krishna, he's in this unfortunate condition, he's unconscious.
因为我们都是 Vrindavan 的居民们，但是看看 Krishna 他现在的这副模样，这让我们也都要死去了。
The gopis, they didn't know who this Gopkumar was. They thought he was just some stranger. He's like a new cowherd boy. They could see he was a cowherd boy, but they didn't know where he was, where he come from.
这些勾皮们，他们并不认识 Gopakumar， 他们以为他只是一个普通的牧牛童。
So they thought he must be some servant of Kamsa. So they were thinking in this way. Gopis were crying in distress, and they all surrounded Krishna, crying, because Krishna's laying on the ground, unconscious. They said, "This must be
Kamsa's servant." And then they began to cry. They surrounded Krishna 呢就躺在地上。
Then, from behind Krishna, there were some cowherds coming. There were more cows and cowherd boys coming. And when they saw Krishna in this condition, they all cried also. They began to cry.
从后面，从 Krishna 的身后。就走过来一些牛犊，还有一些牧牛童，他们看到 Krishna 这幅景象，也都开始哭了起来。
And then, far away, in there was a village far away, and Nanda and the other cowherd men, they could hear the crying, so they all came.And Yashoda also came, because she's very concerned about her son, Krishna.
这从远远的，当 Nanda Krishna 的父亲，还有他的母亲 Yashoda， 他们都是这么关心他们的儿子。当他们听到远处传来的哭泣声，他们也走了过来。
even all the older ladies in the village and the maidservants who are there in the village, they all came running because they could hear people crying and they wondered what was wrong. So they all came to see what's wrong, what's going on.
还有一些老太太以及文达文那些女仆们，他们也都朝这个地方跑了过来，因为他们听到了哭声，他们都在想，发生了什么事？
And the cows and the bulls and all the calves, they all came there, and all the other animals as well. Even the black deer also came. And they, when they all saw Krishna in that condition, they all began to cry. They all began to shed tears.
那些母牛们、公牛们，还有牛犊们也纷纷地奔了过来，还有一些动物以及一些黑鹿，他们也奔了过来。当他们看见 Krishna， 他们也哭了起来，眼中流下了泪水。
Because this is Goloka, and Goloka, all the living entities, they're all pure devotees, and they all love Krishna. So the animal, all these animals, the cows and the deer and everything, they're all crying in love, and their faces are covered with tears. And they came to Krishna and they were smelling and licking him again and again. They would lick his feet and smell him. So all the men, all the women, the animals, they all reacted like that. They were all so much attached to Krishna. Krishna is the person, the main, the only person in their life.
所有的男人、女人、动物们，他们都深深地依附 Krishna. Krishna 是他们生命中唯一的爱的对象。
And there were birds flying in the sky, and the birds, they couldn't see what was going on because it was so crowded. There were so many animals and so many people, but they were sympathetic about it, and they made a sound like people crying.
有些鸟儿们在空中翱翔着，它们看不见下面的情景，因为下面。 的人和那么多动物的，就人头攒动，他们虽然看不见，但是他们内心却怀着巨大的怜悯，他们也发出像哭一样的声音。
And even the creatures which cannot move, like the trees and plants, they were also in great pain. It's like they seem to dry up.
还有一些不动的生物，比如树木、植物，它们也处在巨大的痛苦当中，好像它们都要枯竭了。
So all the living entities, the moving and the non-moving, they were almost on the point of death because they saw Krishna in this condition, so they were almost dying.
所有动和不动的生物们，它们。 看见 Krishna 的这番景象，他们自己几乎就要死去了。So
Gop Kumar, he's very worried. He's thinking what to do now. He's thinking maybe I don't know what to do. I've put Krishna into this condition.
Gop Kumar 就心想，我该怎么办呢？该做什么？
So he put Krishna's lotus feet on his head and he just sat and began to cry and lament.
他就把, 坐了下来，把 Krishna 的莲花烛放在他的头顶，然后他坐在那里就开始嚎啕痛哭起来。
Then Krishna's older brother Balarama came. He was some distance away, but he was coming. He heard about the situation, and so he also came there.
这时候 Krishna 的哥哥 Balarama 也过来了。他离这个地点呢有一点远。那当他听到了这种声音，然后他就也奔了过来。
So Balarama is almost the same age as Krishna, and he's the only difference between him and Krishna is Balarama is white, whereas Krishna is more dark colored. So Balarama is very white complexioned, and he's dressed in blue cloth.
Balarama 和 Krishna 呢几乎是同一个年龄段。他们唯一的区别是 ，Balarama 是肤色非常白皙，他穿着一件蓝色的衣服。
And initially, see, Krishna was coming in front with all the cows and cowherd boys, and when he saw Gop Kumar, then Krishna came running to see Gop Kumar. So Balarama was behind. So Balarama came later.
Krishna 一开始是带着牛犊，还有他的牧牛童朋友，过来。当他看见戈帕库马的时候呢，他就朝着戈帕库马狂奔过来，所以呢，就把巴拉拉玛就远远的撇在后面。
So when he heard what that something had happened to Krishna, Balaram became very worried, and he came forward. He wants to see what's the problem. He's concerned about Krishna's safety.
听到了发生，远处发生的事情，然后他就对 Krishna 就一下子担心起来了。他就想看看到底发生了什么事情，他很担心 Krishna 的安全。
So when he saw Krishna in that condition, he also cried for a moment, but then he composed himself. He regained his composure, and then he looked around, and then with a lot of attention and care, he got Gop Kumar to hold Krishna and to put his arms around Krishna's neck.
巴拉拉玛期间呢，也开始坐在那里哭了起来。后来呢，他就是让自己镇定了下来。他就环顾四周，这时候他看见 Gopa Kumar， 然后他就让 Gopa Kumar 就用他的臂膀就搂着 Krishna 的脖子。
So at first Balarama was crying and he was worried about Krishna, but then he thought, look, we have to do something, have to help Krishna. So he got Gop Kumar, put his arms around Krishna's neck.
一开始巴拉拉玛因为担心 Krishna 也开始哭了起来，但后来呢，他想我们得做些什么事情来帮助 Krishna， 所以他就吩咐 Gopa Kumar 就搂着 Krishna 的脖子。
He could understand why Krishna had fainted, so he's making some arrangement to bring Krishna back to consciousness.
他明白 Krishna晕过去的原因，所以呢，他就做出了一些安排，让 Krishna 再次恢复知觉。
So Lord Balaram took the hand of Gop Kumar and he used it to clean the body of Krishna because it was all covered with dust.
Balarama 呢就拿起 Krishna 的拿就握着 Gopa Kumar 的手。就把 Krishna 身上的尘土掸了下去。
And then he told Gop Kumar to call out Krishna's name, call him loudly. Krishna, Krishna, Krishna.
后来，接下来，帕拉拉玛又告诉 Gopa Kumar 要大声的、高声的 呼唤 Krishna 的名字。
And
Krishna.
Go ahead.
Krishna, Krishna.
Yeah, and then Balarama tells Gop Kumar, he said, now pick Krishna up from the ground. Pick him up.
接下来 Balarama 又吩咐 Gopa Kumar, 你现在就把 Krishna 从地上扶起来。
And that time then Krishna opened his eyes. His eyes had been closed because so much crying. Krishna had been crying so much. But now Krishna opens his eyes and he saw Gop Kumar and he embraced him and kissed him. And he looked at, and then Krishna looked around and he became embarrassed.
Krishna 因为 Krishna 他流了这么多眼泪，以至于呢他都闭上了眼睛。然后这时候他睁开了眼睛，他看见 Gopa Kumar， 然后他就拥抱 Gopa Kumar， 亲吻他。接下来他环顾四周，然后他看到周围这么多人，他变得有点不好意思。
Yeah. So Krishna, he had become.Bewildered because they had so much love for his friend Gop Kumar, it caused them to faint.
Krishna 有一点困惑，因为他对他的朋友怀着这么深厚的爱。
But Krishna was embarrassed to see that it caused so much disturbance because all the people of Vrindavan.They had come to see, to witness what had happened.
Krishna 有一点感到难为情，因为他制造了这么多的他给文达文制造了这么多的骚乱，因为所有文达文的人们都过来，都前来看到底发生了什么事情。
So everyone could see how much love Krishna had.For this cowherd boy from Govardhan.
人人都能看出来 ，Krishna 对于这位来自 Govardhan 山的这个牧牛童，怀着多么强烈的爱。
So, Krishna took the hand of Gop Kumar in his own hand, just like they were all very old friends.And Krishna began to ask questions to him.
Krishna 就用自己的手握住了他的老朋友的手，开始向他提出问题。
So Krishna's friends are very, very dear to Krishna, as dear as Krishna's own life, as dear as Krishna's life is, his friends are also dear to him.
Krishna 的对 Krishna 来说，他的朋友是对他那么亲切，就好像他自己的生命一样。
So, holding Krishna's hand, Krishna holding the hands of Gop Kumar, he would ask him things like, "Are you healthy? Are you happy? Is everything all right?"
Krishna 呢？就握着 Gopa Kumar 的手，就问他：“你健康吗？你快乐吗？一切都好吗？”
And so then Krishna, after he greeted Gop Kumar, then he greeted all these other people of Vrindavan. They'd all come to see because they were worried about Krishna. So he greeted them also.
在 Krishna 问候了他的老朋友之后呢？他又开始问候这些 Vrindavan 的居民们。
So, Krishna goes into the village, along with the people of Vrindavan. But the forest animals, they become miserable because they lose the company, they lose the association of Krishna because he's going into the village. So the forest animals, they cannot go there.
他们就开就进入了文达文的村子，可是这些森林里的动物们因为失去了跟 Krishna 的联谊，就开始变得闷闷不乐，内心就开始痛苦起来，因为他们都走进了村子。
The forest animals, they cannot go anywhere without him, so they simply stood at, they waited at the entrance to the village, and they would spend the whole night outside the village, and they hoped that the next morning Krishna would come and they'd be able to see Krishna again.
这些森林里的动物就没有 Krishna, 他们哪儿也不想去。所以他们就等在这个村子的入口处，渴望着等第二天早晨太阳升起的时候，他们能再次看见他们的朋友 Krishna。
And the birds which were flying in the sky, they were flying over the village to watch Krishna. But when it became dark, then they could no longer see him. Then they would cry, and they'd fly away.
在天空中飞翔的鸟儿们，他们就在村子上空飞翔着，想要看看 Krishna。可是当天色渐晚，暗下来的时候，什么也看不见。这些鸟儿们也都流出了眼泪，他们只好飞走了。
So every living entity in Goloka, including all the forest animals and the birds, they all have.Pure devotion for Krishna.
Goloka 的每一个生物，包括森林里的动物们和那些鸟儿们，都对 Krishna 怀着纯粹的奉爱。
So Nanda Maharaj is always anxious about his children. So after he milked the cows.The two brothers, they went home, and they went home, they didn't even give the cows proper attention. They went home at once because they're very anxious to be with Nanda Maharaj and the home, to be in the home with their father.
他时刻都担心着他自己的孩子们，所以当这个兄弟俩他们给母牛挤完奶之后呢，他们立刻就回家了。他们甚至都没有很好的去关注这些母牛们，就立即回家嘛。因为男的妈妈他特别关心他的孩子，所以这兄弟俩也想马上去回家见到他们的父亲。
No, actually, they've already seen, they're with Nanda Maharaj, but Nanda Maharaj wants them to go home to see Mother Yashoda. So Nanda Maharaj said, you boys must be tired. You've been in the forest all day, walking around the forest all day, you must be tired. So go home and take your bath.And Nanda Maharaj said, I will look after the cows.
Nanda Maharaj 就告诉这两个孩子，你们在森林里走了一天，一定累了。你们现在回家沐浴，我会照顾这些母牛。
So your mother will be unhappy if you don't come home quickly. So go home, take your bath, and then you can take your food also.
如果你们不马上迅速回家的话，你们的母亲就会变得不快乐。所以你们马上回家沐浴，然后吃一些食物。
So Mother Yashoda came along with Rohini. Rohini is the mother of Balarama, and they came to meet the boys and to bring them home.
Yashoda 就过来了，和他一起来的还有 Balarama 的母亲，Rohini.他们就把这两个孩子带回了家中。
Mother Yashoda's clothing and body is always wet with milk flowing from her breasts. because she has so much love for Krishna. So her breasts are always flowing with milk, and then tears are always flooding from her eyes. So her whole body, clothes all wet. And they offered lamps to both the boys. They worshipped him by offering like arti to them. And the different lamp, they would offer a lamp to the different parts of their body. Mother Yashoda would embrace Krishna and kiss him. She didn't know whether she should keep him on her head or at her breast or within her womb. Because if he's in her womb, then she knows she can protect him there. So Krishna brought Gop Kumar there with him to his home, and he had Gop Kumar offer respects to his mother. And when Mother Yashoda saw that Krishna had so much love for Gop Kumar, then Mother Yashoda also embraced him, just like she was, like he was her own son. She picked up Gop Kumar and put him on her lap and embraced him. And then different gopis started to come to the house where Krishna is. Now the gopis came, and some were coming, some would make excuses why they come, and others, they would just come there, they just wanted to be with Krishna. The gopis, they didn't care about what people thought. Some people may say, oh, it's not good, they're going to Krishna's house, they shouldn't go there, they're single girls, they're not married, they shouldn't go after this boy. But the gopis don't care what people say. The gopis just love Krishna, and they don't care about the religious principles also. They just want to be with Krishna and to love Krishna. So Mother Yashoda and Rohini, they were getting ready to give Krishna and Balaram their bath. But when Krishna saw this, he was more eager. Krishna wanted to be with the cowherd girls. He wanted to be with the gopis.
Yashoda和Rohini已经准备好要给Krishna、Balarama沐浴了。可是Krishna却急切地想要跟那些勾皮牧牛姑娘们待在一起。
So they, Krishna told Mother Yashoda and Mother Rohini, he told them, he said, oh, we're very hungry. Please make some rice and get our father to come and feed us right away. We're very hungry.
Krishna 告诉 Yashoda 和 Rohini, 我们好，我们已经饥肠辘辘了，请为我们做一些米饭，让我们的父亲也过来，请立即给我们一些食物，我们特别的饿。
So when the gopis heard this, the gopis, they convinced Mother Yashoda. Mother Yashoda, actually, she's the queen of Vrindavan. So the gopis said to Mother Yashoda, they said very nicely to her, that maybe you better not worry about bathing Krishna just now. Just take care to make food for him.
Gopi们, 他们就说服了 Yashoda. Yashoda, 她是 Vrindavan 的王后。Gopi们就好言好语的就对他要说的妈妈说，也许呢现在你们先不要急着给 Krishna 沐浴，先给赶紧给他们准备些食物。
So gopis are very happy to hear this because it's a chance to Mother Yashoda and Mother Rohini and Balaram, they'll all go away and the gopis can be alone with Krishna.
Gopi 们都很高兴听到这番话，因为这样呢 Balaram 的母亲 Rohini 他们就离开，只留下 Gopi 们他们单独和这兄弟俩待在一起。
So the gopis say to Mother Yashoda, please prepare everything to feed the two boys and we will take care to give a proper bath for them.
Gopi 们就对亚修的妈妈说，请为他们准备一些食物，我们会来为他们这两个男孩子沐浴。
So Mother Yashoda tells the gopis, okay, first you bathe Balaram, and after Balaram's bathed, then send him to bring Nanda Maharaj to come for his food.
Yashoda 妈妈就对 gopi 们说，首先先给 Balarama 沐浴，等 Balarama 沐浴完，让 Balarama 去召唤他的父亲 Nanda Maharaj 过来一起用晚餐。
So then,Gokumar is very happy and pleased with the words of Mother Yashoda. And the gopis, they give Balaram a bath and they sent him to go and bring Nanda Maharaj.
Gopakumar, 他很高兴听到 Yashoda 妈妈的这番话。首先 gopi 们就为 Balarama 沐浴。沐浴完之后，他们让巴拉拉玛去叫他们的父亲南德马哈拉什过来。
Right, the gopis told, you know, Balaram, he's Krishna's older brother. So in the presence of Balaram, the gopis can't show their real feeling for Krishna.
巴拉拉玛是 Krishna 的长兄，在巴拉拉玛面前，这些 Krishna gopi 们，他们无法。真正袒露对 Krishna 的真情。
So usually, just like you never see Radharani where Krishna and Radha and Krishna are together. You never see Balarama where Radha and Krishna are together.
当 Radharani 和 Krishna 待在一起的时候，在他们俩待在一起的时候，你从来看不见 Balarama 的身影。
And when Krishna's with Balarama, Radharani will never come there.
当 Krishna 和 Balarama 在一起，两兄弟哥俩在一起的时候， Gopi 们他们也从来不跟他们混在一起。
So here also, the gopis they send Balarama away to bring Nanda Maharaj, so they can relax and they can feel comfortable to be with Krishna on their own.
Gopi 们就把 Balarama 支走，让他去叫 Nanda Maharaj 过来。 然后当巴拉拉曼离开的之后呢，高品们会感到放松，他们会很舒适的就跟 Krishna 单独待在一起。
And of course when Mother Yashoda and Rohini Muchin, Rohini Mama is also there. If the mothers are there, then the gopis, they cannot enjoy with Krishna. They cannot relax to be with Krishna.
总理，当亚瑟的妈妈和罗希尼母亲在现场的时候，勾品们呢，他们就没办法尽情的享受 Krishna 的陪伴，他们就没办法放松。
So the gopis have service to give Krishna. So they divide up the service among the different gopis. One gopi will help to take off the different ornaments, and they will take off the ornaments from Krishna's body one by one.
Gopi men, 他们对 Krishna 有不同的服务，他们就分工。一个 gopi 们，一位 gopi 会。
So there were many gopis all there. They all wanted to serve Krishna. But it's not possible for all of them to do the same thing at once. So they divided all the work. So each gopi got to take off one of Krishna's ornaments. And then they would wipe Krishna's different bodily limbs because he'd been wearing the ornaments and so much dust. So they would wipe Krishna's body. And they would use their own cloths or their own shawls to wipe the body of Krishna.
接下来他们又擦拭 Krishna 的肢体，因为 Krishna 他佩戴着白天佩戴着饰物，所以他的身上就沾满了尘土。Gopi 们就用他们的布，用他们的头巾擦拭 Krishna 的躯体躯干。
And then they asked Krishna for his flute. But when Krishna is very attached to the flute, he didn't like to give that to the gopis.
接着 gopi 们又向 Krishna 要他的笛子，可是 Krishna 非常依附自己的笛子，不愿意把自己的笛子给 gopi 们拿走。
They tried to snatch it from Krishna's hand, but Krishna was more quick than them. And Krishna threw it to Gop Kumar, who was nearby.
Gopi 们想要从 Krishna 的手中夺走他的笛子，可是 Krishna 的速度更快，他飞速地把他的笛子扔给了站在旁边的 Gopa Kumar。
Krishna doesn't want these gopis to get his flute because he knows the gopis are envious of the flute.
Krishna 不想让 gopi 们拿走他的笛子，他知道 gopi 牧牛姑娘嫉妒他的笛子。
Yeah, Krishna knows maybe the gopis they'll do something with their flute. They'll get rid of it so Krishna can't play his flute anymore.
Krishna 想。也许这些牧牛姑娘会对她的笛子做一些什么事情，可能会把她的笛子给处理掉，所以她不希望与她的笛子分开。
Because the gopis know that the flute is always tasting the nectar from the lips of Krishna.
牧牛姑娘们知道，这根笛子总是在品尝着 Krishna。
So the gopis were saying, give it to me, I'll take it, give it to me. So Krishna didn't want to give it to any of these gopis. So Krishna just threw it into the hands of Gop Kumar.
Krishna 就把这根笛子扔到了 Gopakumar 手中。
So then the gopis covered Krishna's body with nice oils, and any excess oil they would take off with their own hands.
Gopi 们就用一些精美的香油来涂抹 Krishna 的躯体。有一些多余的香油呢，他们就用他们的手就接住了。
And then.Krishna is very naughty. And so what he did was, he made a sound like pain, oh, ow, and he screwed up his beautiful face. And everybody was wondering, what happened?
Krishna 就特别的淘气，他就淘气地发出了个痛苦的叫喊声，哦。然后他美丽的脸庞呢，就扭曲着他美丽的脸庞，旁边的人都担心的，就担心发生了什么事情。
And even Mother Yashoda, who was away in another place, she came running. What has happened? What happened?
就离 Krishna 有一段距离的亚修的妈妈听到了 Krishna 的喊声。就跑了过来，什么事情？发生什么事情？
But she would come there and she would see Krishna smiling, sitting there smiling, and then she know, oh, it's just my son. He's so naughty. And he went, and she would go back into the house.
等他跑过来，就看到 Krishna 坐在那里，就露出了他的微笑。亞瑟的妈妈就心想，哦，我的孩子真调皮。然后他就又回到了房间里面。
So the gopis were laughing and they began to sing and they continued to give Krishna his massage.
那些 gopi 们呢就笑了起来，看到这一幕，然后他们就开唱起了歌，然后在歌声当中继续为 Krishna 按摩。
They know Krishna is very fond of songs, and they also wanted.They didn't want Mother Yashoda to hear any more sounds coming from Krishna. So they finished giving Krishna a massage.Now they have to bathe him, and they want some nice, warm, clear, fragrant water. So they bring the water from the Yamuna.
Gopi 们，他们给 Krishna 按摩了之后呢，接着他们又开始用Yamuna 河的一些清澈的、温暖的、散发着芳香的 Yamuna 河水为 Krishna 沐浴。
And then they dressed Krishna and decorated him just as he likes, with nice clothes and jewelry, beautiful garlands.
之后，牧牛姑娘们就开始为 Krishna 穿着打扮，她们给 Krishna 穿上了美丽的衣服，又给他佩戴上饰物，接着又为他戴上芳香的花环。
And they had different perfumed substances they would bring from their home, and they put them on Krishna.
Gopi 们从家中带来了，散发着香气的香水，芳香的物质，然后他们就为 Krishna 喷上那个芳香的香水。
And then they would.They would feed Krishna something. They would feed him like some butter and some other nice foods. But they would do it secretly because they didn't want Mother Yashoda to know.
接下来，这些牧牛姑娘又开始给 Krishna 一些食物，一些黄油，还有别的食物。他们是秘密的这么做的，因为他们不想让亚瑟的妈妈知道。
Because they're giving Krishna food, it's not his real meal, it's between meals. So they're worried he might, Mother Yashoda will be angry that he may get indigestion or it will ruin his appetite. He won't want to eat his meal when it comes time for his meal. But the gopis want to please Krishna. So they do this secretly, they give him some food.
他们不想让亚瑟的妈妈知道，因为这些食物呢是在两个正餐之前，之间的这个加餐，他们不想让亚瑟的妈妈生气，因为亚瑟的妈妈就会觉得Krishna吃了这些食物会不会消化不良，会不会让他就是没有胃口，在好好的吃正餐了，所以这些gopi们他们希望取悦Krishna。
And then they would worship Krishna, and the different items which they worship Krishna with, they would put them on their head after they'd offered them to Krishna.
接下来他们开始崇拜Krishna，他们把这些不同的物品供奉给Krishna之后，接下来又放在自己的头上。
And then they would decorate his throat and his forehead and his cheeks. They'd put wonderful designs there, made from like sandalwood paste or made from saffron. They'd put them on his different on the his parts of his body.
他的额头，他的喉咙，他的脸颊，他们就画上不同的式样的图案，就用檀香浆，用一些姜黄粉来为 Krishna 装点他的脸。
And then they would put the different makeup around Krishna's eyes, the collyrium on his lotus eyes to make them shine.
接着呢，他们又给 Krishna 化妆，在他的眼睑，给他涂上这个黑眼膏，使他的这个眼睛呢就闪闪发光。
So in this way, they're decorating Krishna very nicely.
他们就这样用心地装点着Krishna。Okay,
we will stop here today.
那今天我们的讲课部分到这里。Are
there any questions?
Yes.
Okay.
Some questions.
Yes.
感谢马尔，感谢主持。 Gopa Kumar 属于圣人的范畴吗？ There are several questions. The first one is, does Gopa Kumar belong to the category of saints, sages, sadhu?
Gop Kumar is a cowherd boy from Govardhan. He is.
Gopa Kumar.
How do we call him a saint? Well, certainly he's gone to the spiritual world and he's met Krishna and Krishna knows him, so he's a pure devotee.
是来自哥瓦丹山的一位牧牛童，他去了灵性世界，他遇见了 Krishna， 而且 Krishna 也知道他，所以 Gopa Kumar 他是纯粹的奉献者。You're
asking, is he a saint? He's certainly a holy man.
所以你问他是不是圣人，他肯定是一位圣人。
But he's always a boy. He's been given a blessing by his guru that he wouldn't grow old. He remains as a cowherd boy. So he's young. So we don't think of these young boys like saints.
但是呢，他是一个男孩子的形象，因为他得到了他guru的祝福，他不会变老，他会一直保持着他的样子。所以他总是年轻的男孩子的样子。
But we see the four Kumaras, they're also sons of Brahma, they're also saints, and they're like young children.
我们也知道，四位库玛他们是主 Brahma 的儿子，他们都是圣人，但是他们的样子全是年轻的孩子的样子。
Okay.
The second question is, what's the definition for a sadhu, holy man?
Well, there are qualities. If you read the third canto, Lord Kapila's teaching, the qualities of a sadhu are described.
就是依赖他们的品质。如果你读圣典不加瓦坛第三篇。Kapila Dev 描述了萨度圣人的品质。
Yeah, Lord Kapila was telling his mother Devahuti that she has to become attached to a sadhu, and so Lord Kapila describes a sadhu. He describes all the qualities of a sadhu, and he describes the activities of the sadhu.
主 Kapila Dev 就训示他的母亲应当依附圣人。接着 Kapila Dev 描述了圣人的品质以及圣人的活动。
So, the qualities are described. Tatikshava Karunika Suridam Sarvadehinam Ajata Satravam Sattva Sadhava Sadhu Bhushana. Qualities, first of all, tolerant and merciful, friendly to all living entities.
Kapila Dev 这个品圣人的品质就是容忍、仁慈，对一切众生有爱。
He has no enemy, and
他没有。
He knows the scriptures, and he can apply the teachings of the scriptures.
他没有敌人，他了解，他暗熟经典，而且他知道如何运用经典。
And all of his ornaments, all of his qualities are very pleasing. So this is how we understand the sadhu. You can read third canto, chapter 25 of Srimad Bhagavatam. And it's text number 2021, like that. Okay, go ahead.
这些内容是在《圣典不加瓦坛》第二十五篇，二十章、二十一章。
二十五。
第二十五章。Oh, sorry. 二十五章。Is the next part of the question is that 有不同层面的圣人。Are there different levels for these sadhus?
Yes. Just like devotees, you've got kanista, you've got madhyam, you've got uttama.
是的，就像奉献者有初级奉献者、中级奉献者、高级奉献者。
You've got impersonalists, you've got personalists.
有非人格主义者，有人格主义者。
So sadhu can also be an impersonalist. He may not be a devotee.
一位萨杜圣人，他也可能是一位非人格主义者，他并不是奉献者。
So there are different kinds of sadhu, even there are different kinds of devotees. Some devotees are prema bhaktas, they have love of God. Some devotees don't have that kind of, they're only bhava bhakti, and some devotees are doing vaidhi bhakti according to rules and regulations.
就像奉献者有不同的种类，有的是 prema bhakta， 处在神爱当中的，还有的是 bhava bhakta， 还有 vaidhi bhakta。
Yeah. Even among Vaidhi Bhakti, according to rules and regulations, some people are doing spontaneous devotion, somehow Raga Bhakti, they have spontaneous devotion to Krishna. So there are different levels of the sadhus and different levels of devotees.
What's the highest level of for the saints, sadhu?
Prema bhakta. Love of God, one who has got Krishna Prem, that's the highest sadhu. Yes.
It is said that in Brahman realization, there is only the part of realizing the eternity, only part of the knowledge. There is no realization of the Ananda. Yet in Bhagavad Gita, it is described that one who is in Brahman realization has become fully blissful. My question is that whether they are the Ananda part for the realization of the blissful part, Ananda part in Brahman realization.
Yeah, Brahman realization is not going to be the same Ananda as one will get in devotional service.
Brahman 觉悟呢，和一位已经处在就是在奉献服务当中，已经拥有了 Ananda 觉悟的奉献者是不一样的。Brahman.
The happiness from Brahman is like one drop of water compared to the ocean of devotional service. So there is some happiness in the Brahman, but nothing compared to the happiness and love of God.
在Brahman饭的觉悟当中有一丝一些快乐，但是跟对神的爱的快乐是无法比拟的。The
happiness of Brahman is no more suffering of the material world.
饭觉的快乐就是已经不再有物质世界的痛苦了。
Yes. So that is happiness for some people, but that's nothing compared to the happiness one gets from devotional service.
对, 所以这, 对于某, 些人来说这是他们的快乐，但是这与奉献服务是根本无法媲美的。下一个是来自于这一位一串数字，这个手机号，顶拜咕噜老师们，请叫咕噜。在生活当中，我是一个性急着急的人，有时把这种着急带到学习上，可能会带给一些共同学习的奉献者困扰。比如，我很渴望和奉献者一起学习进步的时候，有时有可能在有意无意当中给他们造成学习上精神上压力，而忽略到他们当下的承受力和心理需求。请问咕噜，这算不算是一种暴力呢？我应该如何调整，让自己变得温柔耐心一些，以对方能接受的方式针对不同的人，以他们能够接受的方式在 Krishna 知觉里愉快成长呢？感恩。
这个是谁的问题？
他只是一个手机号，一串数字，没有写他的名字，是一个手机号。So, this devotee paid obeisance to guru and teachers. In the practical life, my temperament is a little bit worried, rushy. I want to get things done very quickly. Sometimes during the course of study, maybe it will cause disturbance to other devotees. For example, I am very much want to study with devotees, but sometimes this may put some pressure to them, both during the course of study and spiritual, in a psychological pressure, and may ignore their endurance and demand their psychological demand. So my question is that, Guru, can this be accounted as a kind of violence? And so how should I make adjustment that I may become more softer and gentle and to deal with others in a manner that they can accept and we can grow up very pleasantly in Krishna consciousness? Thank you.
Well, I don't think it's violence. I don't think definitely your intention is not there to be violent. I don't think it's violence. It's just something which, you know, the devotees will have to get a little used to, that you're like that, that you rush things and you have a different kind of mood than they have.
我认为这不是暴力，只是你的目的、你的宗旨跟他们不一样。他们需要习惯一下。你喜欢，你的性子比较急，就是你跟他们有不同的心态。
The main thing is that you have the desire to study. That's very good, and you just have to calm down. You have to slow down a bit and. You can do this, you just take some more time, you have to chant, you have to do more chanting of the holy name, and then this way it will help you to slow down a bit and not to be so much influenced by the mode of passion.
So, 需要平静下来，让自己的速度放慢 要花时间，就是多念诵圣名，多念诵圣名可以帮助你放缓你的速度，做事速度，就让你不会那么受到激情形态的影响了。
And because you have a material body, your body is also older, getting older, and as you get older, you will naturally slow down and you'll lose this passion.
您也有一个物质躯体，那随着这个物质躯体，这个慢慢的变老，自然而然的你就会慢慢的放慢你的速度，就减缓这个激情的影响。
So don't worry, continue to study and associate with the devotees and be humble, be very humble, offering respect to them.
不要担心，继续学习与奉献者联谊。变谦卑，要向奉献者们致敬。
Humility is very important quality, and that will be recognized by the devotees. If you have genuine humility, then they will all appreciate it, and they will be happy to have you in their association.
谦卑是非常重要的品质。如果你有谦卑的品质，奉献者们自然而然的就会认出这个品质，真心实意的欣赏这个品质，而且快乐的与你，在你的联谊当中共处。
And better you don't put demands on the devotees. Don't demand things. Don't start questioning and doing things or asking things which are not.Done. Let the devotees do everything, let them organize everything, and just simply take part in their program to study and to hear and to chant.
最好不要提要求，向奉献者们提要求，也不要提就是种种的问题，让奉献者们去做事，让奉献者们去组织，你只需要去参与，然后去参加他们的这些组织的这些活动，一起学习。
Yeah, don't try to change the devotees, leave them. You just try to do like them and be like them.
不要试图改变奉献者，让他们去按照他们的方式去做事情，然后呢就要像这些奉献者们一样。
It's better if you can change yourself rather than you try to change them.
最好是你改变你自己，而不是去改变别人。
So if you spend more time with the devotees, then gradually you will also become like them.
如果你和奉献者们待的时间更多的话，逐渐的就会和奉献者们一样了。
Yeah. But there, we have this saying in China, "Wuyi Lei Zhu," Birds of the feather.Birds of the feather flock together.
中文有句谚语叫物以类聚，人以群分。在英文当中的直译过来就是，长着同样羽毛的鸟会待在一起。
So you try to stay in that association, be with the devotees, and develop their qualities, their nature.
所以你就待在奉献者的联谊当中，就跟他们，培养出跟他们一样的品质和他们一样的天性了。
And be patient, and be tolerant, and be humble.
变得耐心，变得容忍，变得谦卑。
Don't try to control.
不要试图控制。
Just be a humble servant. You come to the association of devotees to hear and to chant. Of course, if you have questions, you can ask also, that's all right.
当然，如果你有问题，可以提问题。
But the questions should be, they should not, questions should not be challenging.
但是这些问题不应该是挑战的问题。
They should be reasonable questions, just simply help to questions which are made to help you understand more the philosophy of Krishna consciousness.
这些问题应当是合情合理的问题，帮助你能够理解 Krishna 之觉的哲学。
And if you cannot get the answer, then you can always put the question here on this program and we can answer at the classes in the morning. When devotees give class, at that time you can ask questions also. Okay. Any other? Are you waiting, ma? Generally, we say the mushrooms are in the mode of ignorance because they grow in the dark place. They don't grow in the sunlight.
通常我们说菌类属于愚昧形态，是因为它们生长的在黑暗的地带，而不是生长在阳光下。
I've never heard other reasons why it's in the mode of ignorance.
没听说还有其他的
But we're encouraged to eat food which is more in the mode of goodness. Krishna, we didn't hear, we know Krishna doesn't eat mushrooms. In the Vedic culture, people in the Vedic culture, they're not eating mushrooms. There were no mushrooms in India, so Krishna never ate any mushrooms. So we like to offer, we offer our food to Krishna, and I don't know if Krishna would. Of course, if you're going to eat mushrooms, you should offer them, but it's not something which Krishna particularly likes. Our custom is in the temple, we don't offer mushrooms on the altar to the deities.
Krishna, Guru Mani Madanji， 在这个问题之上面还有一个关于联谊的问题，是不是 漏掉的？
因为我是刚
手机的，
不是我这个电脑，它是我没有看到那个，我只看到那个，没看到那个问题联谊没看到。
就是我念一下啊，顶拜咕噜和老师们，请教咕噜关于联谊的问题。是否每个初级奉献者都需要一段时间小心翼翼避开物质圈子，尽可能在知识和规范的学习中保护和稳定自己的灵性觉悟呢？这种情况算不算是看不起非奉献者的傲慢和修偏了呢？如果长期不和奉献者联谊，心意和认知都明显受到非奉献者的影响，而且在躯体和情感上越来越依赖家人，甚至把家人朋友一些错误认知当作奉爱标准来看，请问在这样的状态下，虽然奉献者也会依然保持每天念诵圣名和聆听课程，这样的情况算不算是已经受到了打扰呢？请问咕噜有何训示？我想这位奉献者可能是苏迪如法，我猜的。
不知道，可能。Can you translate some of it, Guru Mani?
Yes. So this question is about something about the material circle of life.If we stay in the association of devotees, regulative association with devotees, we are protected. But if we stick in the devotee association and will not leave this circle, will that be accounted as a kind of pride and look down upon those who are non-devotees?But yet, on the other hand, if we stay in the association of non-devotees, our mind will be polluted and our feeling and psychology will also be affected by non-devotees and will accept their wrong ideas as right.
Yes.
So.萨蒂玛德吉，我忘了第三部分是什么，他的问题是什么？
他第一部分就是说，
他的问题是什么？啊、看不起。
就是他看起来是不是就是这种态度？看不起非奉献者的傲慢的态度是不是修偏了？这是第一部分的问题。嗯。
Okay. So the first part of the question is that will this attitude be counted as those a kind of pride that is looked down upon non-devotees? Will that be a deviation in our spiritual practice?
Well, we should have appreciation for the association of devotees. We should feel fortunate to be in the association of devotees. And we shouldn't look down on the non-devotees, but we should feel some compassion for them. We shouldn't think we are any different. We're not so different from the other people. Although we're devotees, we should think we're very fortunate to have got the mercy of Krishna consciousness and to come into Krishna consciousness. That's our good fortune, and we should want to make other people also fortunate. We definitely don't want to think we're better than them. We're not different actually from other people. Prabhupada would feel compassion. He always felt sorry for these other people that they haven't had the opportunity to come to Krishna consciousness. In Christianity, they talk about judge the sin and not the sinner. The problem is with the life, the activities which people have. It's not the fault so much of the people, but it's just the environment which they're in.
在基督教中有一句话叫做你审判那个罪恶而不是你去评判这个罪恶而不是去评判这个罪人，正是因为他们的生活与他们的活动使得他们就是在人生当中犯了错误，由于他们的生长环境使得他们犯下错误。
So we want to try to help people, to give Krishna consciousness to them, try to bring them to Krishna consciousness. Don't want to look down on them, don't want to reject them.
We are trying to help people, give Krishna consciousness, to bring them to Krishna consciousness.我们不会瞧不起他们，也不会摒弃他们，抛弃他们。
So, We have to associate with devotees, and we have to also live in the material world. We have to also associate with people who are not devotees. We just have to be careful not to be affected by the association of non-devotees, not to criticize them, and not to take up their bad habits. So, you have to do it with caution. You have to be cautious when you're with non-devotees. You have to be cautious, and when you're with devotees, you have to take advantage of the association of devotees to strengthen your Krishna consciousness, so that you can be with people who are not devotees and not be affected by them.
你要非常小心小心翼翼地与非奉献者交往，当与奉献者在一起的时候，要充分地利用跟奉献者的联谊，来加强巩固自己的Krishna知觉。当与非奉献者在一起的时候，要不要受到他们的影响。
Okay, Chitali Winti.
下一部分，他问就是与非奉献者联谊，然后长期的不和奉献者联谊，在跟非奉献者联谊的过程当中，在情感和躯体上，越来越依赖家人，并且就是把家人的一些错误认识看成是妨碍服务。他问这样，虽然是每天在听课呀、念诵啊，算不算已经受到了打扰？
Long time in long term with non-devotee family members and became attached to these family members. Although I still carry out devotional service like Shravana Kirtana, listen classes every day and chanting. So is that this is still affected by non-devotees. Yes, because in my feeling, I became attached to the family members and also accept some of their wrong ideas.
Yes, that's the problem. That you have family members who are not devotees. But what to do? You cannot give up your family. You cannot give up your family members. So you have to try to balance. You have to understand what is good and what is not good.
但是你又不能放弃这些家人，所以要努力地去平衡，明白是非，明白好坏。 明白哪些是好的，明白哪些是不好的。
You have to become very tolerant with your family members. You shouldn't put too many obstacles onto them, but don't try to disturb the situation in your home. And at the same time, you have to try also to remain Krishna conscious.
要容忍家人。 不应当给他们制造障碍，也不要打扰了家庭的气氛，但是要保持 Krishna 之觉。
So we wish you good luck.
我们祝您好运。
We know it's not easy, so you try.
我们知道这不容易，所以你要努力。
Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个问题，来自 Divya Shakti， 顶拜 Guru Dev， 请问《博伽瓦坛》第三篇28章圣恩帕帕德在钥匙中说：“一减一等于一，一加一还是等于一。”我不是很理解，请 Guru Dev 能给解释一下吗？谢谢。So, obeisance Gurudev, though in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter 28, Srila Prabhupada said in the purport that 1 minus 1 equals 1, 1 plus 1 also equals 1. I cannot understand
okay. Very
much.
Okay, so Prabhupada's explaining.That Krishna plus everything is still Krishna because Krishna is everything. Everything comes from Krishna. So Krishna is one, and if you add everything, it's still one. Right? You can't have anything more. There's nothing which is not in Krishna. Everything is within Krishna.
Krishna 加上一切就等于 Krishna， 因为 Krishna 就是一切， Krishna 一切是来源于 Krishna， Krishna 就等于一加上一切，就 Krishna 就是一加上一切还等于一。
Then what?
因为没有更多的不在 Krishna 之中，一切都在 Krishna 之中。
One minus one, if you have Krishna and you take everything away from Krishna, you're still left with Krishna. So one minus one is equal to one. So this is called spiritual mathematics.
这就叫灵性的数学。
One plus one is equal to one, Krishna. Krishna plus everything is equal to Krishna. And Krishna minus everything is still Krishna.
Krishna 就一加一等于一。Krishna 加上一切还是 Krishna， 那一减一等于一，就是 Krishna 减去一切还是 Krishna。
下一个问题。
下一个。下一个是。Smoky 不对，庞继东这看不见。对不起，这个庞继东这个什么问题啊？那就下一个先 ，Smoky Rada， 顶拜古鲁玛拉日和翻译主持们，一位新朋友问：佛教徒会以各种方式冥想各种净土，比如画坛城等等。佛经中也有很多描述净土的构造的部分，令人神往。奉爱经典中哪些部分是描述？哪些部分是描述灵性世界温达文的构造呢？我们是否也应该对温达文的这些描述进行冥想呢？感恩您。 马儿，稍等一下。萨提玛大姐，哈里波，
哈里波，
哈里克什纳，嗯 ，Good day，
嗯，
需要你读这些中文吗 ？OK，
对呀，对，问题的中文要读。
OK，So this from Smoky Rada on behalf of new person， a new person。Ask the question that the Buddhists, they will meditate by various ways, different pure light. For example, they would draw pictures of yantra. In the Buddhist sutra, there are many part about how the pure land is formed. The form of the pure land is very attractive. So in our Bhakti Sutra, where is the in which part is description about the construction of Vrindavan in spiritual world? So there are two question marks.The others, should we also meditate on Vrindavan according to this description? Thank you.
Well, first of all, Vrindavan in the spiritual world is not constructed, it's eternal, it's always existing.
Sorry, maybe, 构造。This new friend said that the form of the pure land described in the Buddhist sutra. So in Bhakti sutra.In which part is the description about the Gozo? A formation of Vrindavan in the spiritual world.
So it's there in Srimad Bhagavatam. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it's all there. You can read Srimad Bhagavatam. And it's also here in this book, which I'm reading, the Brihad Bhagavatamrita every morning. We've been reading this Brihad Bhagavatamrita, it's described there. But it's also there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. You can read about, about the four Kumaras going to the spiritual world. I think it's the fourth canto.
在《博伽瓦坛》的第四篇，四库马尔兄弟去灵性世界，就描述了灵性世界的构造。
There's also a brief.
我们的每天早上，我们的早上的圣大博伽瓦坛讲的课当中也描述了。
There's a brief mention of the spiritual world, two slokas in the Bhagavad Gita, which describe the spiritual world, in chapter 8 and in chapter 15.
在博伽梵歌当中也有两个世界描述灵性世界，在第八章和第十五章分别是。
But in detail, it's described in Srimad Bhagavatam.
但是细节是在圣典博伽瓦坛当中得以描述。
Okay.
So he also. She also asked, should we meditate on Vrindavan according to this description?
Yes, you can do.
是的，可以。
Okay.
The next one's from Harini. 顶拜 Guru Dev, 顶拜所有的奉献者。请问 Guru Dev, 我们在物质世界生存时会做出对事物的错误选择，所以必将为错误选择承担后果。可是我们学了 Krishna 知觉后，同样也会做错误选择，那同样结果我们还是需要自己承担的结果呢？那请问 Guru, 我们如何在继续学习 Krishna 知觉中让自己减少错误的选择呢？Business to Gurudev, business to all devotees. I ask Gurudev that we are living in this material world, and we have made wrong choice. Therefore, we have to suffer the result from those wrong choice. Yet, after we learn Krishna consciousness, we will also make wrong choice, and the same result we have to.Bear, suffer the result. My question that, so how can we learn, during the course of learning Krishna consciousness, we can reduce the wrong choice?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, by becoming Krishna conscious, we will reduce our wrong choice, right? Krishna will give us the intelligence to make proper decisions, good decisions.
通过变得有 Krishna 之觉， Krishna 会给我们智慧，做出正确的决定，做出好的决定。
Before becoming devotees, we only think about our own sense gratification, and we don't think about Krishna, so it's very good that you become a devotee and you surrender to Krishna, and then Krishna will guide us from the heart what is the proper action to take.
In becoming a devotee, we think about Krishna, we think about Krishna, and we don't think about Krishna.而当我们成为奉献者之后呢，我们会臣服 Krishna， Krishna 会在心中指导我们如何做出正确的，采取正确的活动。
All right, 还有问题吗？
下一个 ，Yes， 顶拜 Guru Dev， 这是从哪个奉献者的？不太清楚，顶拜 Guru Dev， 顶拜所有的奉献者。这个 continue the question from Harini， maybe。那请问 Guru， 既然灵性天空的 Goloka Vrindavan 跟印度的 Vrindavan 一样，那么 Goloka Vrindavan 的居民是会不会也要经历死亡与出生呢？还是他们都是灵性的身体？感恩姑的回答。
Yeah.
Although,
Okay, go ahead. Translate.
Yes. So since in the spiritual sky, the Vrindavan Goloka is the same as Vrindavan in India.Then the residents of Vrindavan Goloka, do they have to suffer death and birth, or they have a spiritual body?
Yeah, in Goloka, they have spiritual bodies. They don't suffer birth and death. But on the earthly planet, we have to take birth and die.
在Goloka，他们有灵性的躯体，但是在地球上还要投生和死亡。
So the people who live in Vrindavan, they live in Vrindavan and they're conscious of Vrindavan. So next life, when they give up their body, they can go back to the spiritual world, Vrindavan in the spiritual world. So it's their last birth in the material world. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Gurudev. 我们后面还有五个问题，因为现在时间已经九点了，不知道您还有时间继续回答吗？
没有，因为七点钟，我只有二十分钟，还需要讲一节课。二十分钟以后，我需要讲。
还二十，那我们把后面的问题留到下次课吧。
可以。星期六晚上，还是
可以。
星期六晚上也可以。
好的好的，我把这些问题记下来，然后星期六晚上再转给您。
OK。好，今天我们讲到这儿，我们感谢 Guru Mani 给我们翻译，感谢萨提主持，祝福奉献者，长寿并快乐，万事如意 ，Hare Krishna。Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki.
Jai.
Gaur Premanande Haribol.